different angle, something that I think we have a little bit more management control and a handle on, that is likely to bear considerably beneficial results. And that is the suggestion that we, as I said earlier, we form an educational system in the state.
Thank you. Tim Fitzgerald first. What is your position on the CAL FIRE parcel fee tax?
I think in fact it's a property tax that the taxpayer paid for the fire program here in the district, if I'm not mistaken. That gets down to a real severe problem that was found way back when we started this thing. And they wanted the county to pay tax on deed to pay for getting deeds that are, you know, high up. They felt, the condos felt that that tax reform might be entire campfires. I agree in principle. I think that that's a state,
Make a good deal about that. The fundamental purpose of government is public safety. Everything else is sold down to this. Public safety includes law enforcement, prisons, fire suppression. I oppose the SRFP. It's unconstitutional, and I believe will be held unconstitutional because it didn't pass the two-thirds muster required by Proposition 26. So I think it's going to be going anyway. Now, what it is an example of how government takes a fundamental purpose and withholds funds from it to extort more money out of us. They say, well, we can't pay for law enforcement. We can't pay for fire suppression. We must have a new tax. And rather than focusing attention on the fundamentals, California has 12% of the nation's population, and we have 34% of the welfare recipients. You know, we got our priorities turned upside down. A government that rewards failure and punishes success gets more failure and less success.
This is probably the most difficult issue. I'm trying to answer it in a minute. It's also very difficult. But the $150 fire fee was brought up by the budget that was passed in September. When, you know, the other side refuses to raise any more revenue, but they demand services. They want services, but they don't want to pay for them. Well, isn't that amazing? Well, you know, we need fire protection. That's number one. If the state is unable to provide fire protection, then fire stations get closed. They put the burden on the local districts, and the local districts may not be able to control a large fire, so we have more damage. So fire protection is number one. It's an unfair tax. I agree with that. I was in Sacramento a couple of weeks ago, and I went into about 8 different legislative offices to talk to them about this fire fee, and I told them it was unfair.
Thank you, Mark. Okay, the next up are 1 minute questions. Let's see, Rico to start. Rico, would you support drug testing for welfare recipients?
I'd love it. We'll spend the $80 to take them down and have a test. One of our guys has to take half a day off work to test positive. Happens all the time. Drug abuse is a huge problem in the workplace, but it's even a bigger problem amongst, I believe, amongst welfare recipients. And absolutely, we should drug test. Why should we be spending our money? You know, the beauty of charity is the church. When someone comes there for help, they come to me and they want me to help them. I don't just say changes in their conduct. They've done things in their lives, usually, not always, but usually something's happened. They've made some bad choices that put them in a bad way in life. And so I don't want to just give money to them. I want to give them help. I want to give them encouragement. I want to give them counseling and some new direction. And maybe it also requires some discipline. But that's better for society than just giving money away.
And Mark, would you support drug testing for welfare recipients?
I was hoping to talk about education.
this is a very strange circumstance. Frank also opposed Prop 26. Prop 26 is what prevents government from raising taxes without a two-thirds threshold by calling them something besides taxes, fees or levies or whatever else. They'll raise the tax that way and say it's not a tax, they don't meet the two-thirds threshold. Frank Bickel voted against that. And I'm really familiar with Prop 98, the recent one. Prop 98 related to the Kelo decision, which was a property rights decision made by the Clinton Court that related to a public entity that the city of New London took a private property from a lady to deed it to another private land developer because the purpose would be creating more tax revenue, more setting more property tax. That is inconsistent with what the Constitution demands as far as I'm concerned as regards eminent domain. So 40 states passed bills to make sure that didn't happen in their states. California attempted it, of course, with the control of the Democrats and legislature didn't pass. And Frank, at the time, was on the board of California State Association of Counties. I think he was president of CSAC at the time. And that organization voted unanimously to spend $1.3 million in opposition to Proposition 98. That shows a stark contrast between the conservative and the liberal, and I hope you can use that in the vote.
Across the board, truth, the
start making friends on the water. Bigfoot.